8 years.
People said we wouldn't last. Happy anniversary, baby.
Happy anniversary.
Preparing just in case any military bases are forced to close. A bill creating a task force if a base closes is headed to the Senate floor. The task force would examine ways to improve the market value of the U.S. military facilities and ways to benefit communities if the base is closed. The House has already approved the bill. Labor union officials are set to meet with House Democrats next week. The House Small Business Committee passed the Right to Work bill Wednesday and sent it to the House floor for debate. House Speaker Larry Adair says state AFL-CIO President Jim Curry and other labor officials will speak to the House to explain why they oppose the measure. The current bill would allow for a statewide vote in August on the right to work issue. Well, new this morning, Terry Nichols' defense team has not requested an interview with Timothy McVeigh about his comments in his upcoming book. Attorney Nathan Chambers says neither Nichols' defense team or Oklahoma prosecutors have asked a question McVeigh. McVeigh's book may reveal details about who is responsible for the bombing. News 9's legal analyst Irvin Bach says if in fact McVeigh claims sole responsibility for the bombing in the book, he could be asked to testify for Nichols' state trial, and that could delay McVeigh's execution. Also new this morning, Tecumseh school officials say they will head back to court over a random drug testing policy. The 10th U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals in Denver ruled the policy unconstitutional. Now the Tecumseh School Board has made the decision to appeal the ruling. And the school's drug testing policy randomly tested students in extracurricular activities. The lawsuit originated from two students who participated in non-athletic activities. For now, the school is not testing anyone. Let's go to Jed Castles now and get a look at that weather. And Jed, what do we have in store for this weekend?
Well, we're dealing with a little fog this morning, Stacy. Let's check out the latest view from our roof cam. And boy, it's bright, bright sunshine going on. We have a few high clouds out there. We also have some areas of fog around the metro. At our location right here, fog not a problem. There are some other areas, though, around the metro, especially in the low-lying areas, the river valleys, seeing some pretty dense fog here starting out this morning. So if you're in the fog, just be careful. Watch out this morning. Should be seeing that fog lift and should turn out to be a nice day for most of Oklahoma. Let's check out your forecast for the next 7 days. And looks like those highs will top out near 61 today. Partly cloudy, fog lifting this morning. Well, another one of those transition days for your Saturday, but it's not going to last. We'll be cooling through the 50s tomorrow. Chance of rain 30% and some gusty winds coming up too. And then 60s and even 70s back on the way as we go into next week. Another stormy pattern setting up by the middle to latter part of next week. We'll be tracking that closely. More details on your weekend weather coming up.
All right. Thank you, Jed. A national organization's Oklahoma City branch is asking people all over the state to volunteer for one day. Ed Murray's in our Bricktown studio this morning with organizers of CareLift 2001. Ed, this day of volunteering will help 7 agencies and shelters in Oklahoma City.
Stacy, it's amazing what you can do with just one day of volunteering. Joining me from Heart to Heart International is Deanna Thomason, Barbie Moore, and Rocky Bowdish from Federal Express. They're all part of this thing. And Deanna, why don't you first start, tell us about CareLift.
Hey, CareLift is a national day of service that started 4 years ago with Heart to Heart. And we are going to be going out tomorrow to about 7 agencies here in the Oklahoma City area, just doing various work projects. We'll be doing landscaping, painting, various things. And if they'd like to be involved, they can come out to the service center at 50th and Rockwell and at 8:30 and join us.
And we're going to give folks a phone number here in a few minutes that they can call as well. Barbie, tell us a little bit about Heart to Heart International.
Heart to Heart was founded in 1992, and since that time, we've given away over $200 million worth of product all over the world. But it was 4 years ago now that we began this national care lift, really a way that people right here in our local communities can get involved in agencies that are helping the needy in our own city. So as Deanna said, tomorrow is our day of service, but it's actually happening in about 6 to 8 cities tomorrow. We're one of those cities and we're thrilled. But people might say, well, how do you get this product into the cities all over the country? And that has been donated by Federal Express all of these years. And we're honored to have the ramp manager with us today that's going to be in charge of this operation tomorrow.
Rocky, we got to get those supplies in here from Kansas City, don't we?
That's true. We're honored as FedEx to help Barbie and the Heart to Heart program and just to be able to commit to them all of our resources to take the transportation needs to deliver not only here in Oklahoma City but across the United States and all the organizations. And we've been with them from the beginning and we hope for many more years with them.
And that's a lot of medical supplies coming in. And again, Deanna, one day of service is all you're asking. It's tomorrow.
Right. Just one day of service tomorrow, 8:30 at the service center. And then we'll conclude about 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
All right. Thank you very much and good luck. And again, one day of your time can make a huge, huge difference. Stacy?
All right. Thank you, Ed. The 4th annual Care Lift event kicks off tomorrow morning. If you would like to help out tomorrow, call this number. It's there on your screen, 787-5200. That's at extension 102. We'll be back.
What do you need to know about Reynolds Ford Truck Month? Said.
He's not a bad guy. On the contrary, he's a very decent human being. His associates like and respect him. He's a caring father and a good husband. But today, the 37 people he comes in contact with will die a little because they were forced to breathe the smoke from his cigarette. Secondhand smoke. It takes more than your breath away.
Imagine standing inside a tornado of fire. CBS Tuesday, David Copperfield will attempt to do just that live.
Never stand and steal your fire.
Wind strong enough to blow your roof off. Heat hot enough to melt steel. No tricks, no special effects, no room for error. Getting out alive will be a miracle. David Copperfield, Tornado of Fire, live CBS Tuesday.
Hey, listen up. I've got something I want to tell you. I'm not going to tell anybody else. It's about where you need to go for the best prices on Ford cars, trucks, vans, and SUVs. Yeah, yeah. If you want to save money on your next Ford car, truck, van, or SUV, you've got to come see us here
at Hudiburg Ford.
Hudiburg Ford sells 2001 F-150 Supercab XLTs for $19,700 or buy the Ranger Edge with no money down and $235 a month.
If you want the lowest price on a new Ford,
come see us here at Hudiburg Ford.
I can't help myself. Bad horse.
Welcome back. This weekend will be 1 hour shorter than usual. That's because we will spring forward to daylight savings. This weekend, you'll want to set your clocks forward 1 hour. Officially 2 a.m. Sunday will become 3 a.m., but if you're not awake for that, just remember to change your clocks before you go to bed Saturday night. Let's go to Jed Castles now, get a look at that weather. A little foggy out there.
Yeah, dense fog right now up around Guthrie. Fog visibility is less than a quarter of a mile. Folks in southern Logan County dealing with some thick fog, and that's the case in other locations too. Maybe in your backyard, or if you live in a low-lying area, you may have some fog this morning. It should lift quickly here as we go through the morning hours. Let's check out those conditions. That's a view from our Integra City Cam. 37 degrees, winds calm, humidity right there at 100%, pressure steady, 29.89. You can see there's some light fog in that shot right there, but no dense fog going on along Northwest Expressway up near the Hefner Parkway. Morning conditions around the metropolitan area. Again, Guthrie checking in with some dense fog, calm winds, and 36 degrees. Midwest City, some fog and 39. Shawnee, 39 with calm winds. And Chandler at 37. They have some fog. West winds at 4. Right now around the state, we've got some 30s going on, a few 40s in the state. 42 Hobart. Compare that to 31 right now up around Ponca City. So it is a cold morning starting off. It's a dry morning for most of Oklahoma. The only rain we can find is in far southern sections of Oklahoma. That's where the best chances of rain will be today. Better chances as you head down into Texas. So if you are traveling into Texas, a little bit of wet weather there. You can see this old system rolling on through. And that'll be pushing on across. Partly cloudy to mostly cloudy skies into Oklahoma coming up for today. Better chance of thicker clouds through southern Oklahoma. Despite the clouds, we're still forecasting warmer temperatures today, up in the low 60s for most of Oklahoma. Across the nation, mild weather covering the central part of the country. We're tracking colder air to our north. Here it comes. That'll be barreling back down into the plains. That colder air will be shifting down into Oklahoma for your Saturday. It's not going to last, though. Not like this pattern we've been in. This little brunt of cooler air is going to quickly shift by. And by the time we get into the first part of next week, we'll be back up in the upper 60s and low 70s across most of Oklahoma. Could even be warmer than that in a few locations by the time we get into Tuesday. So warmer weather is in the forecast as we get into next week. Today, we'll call it light winds. Chance of a shower in southern and southwestern Oklahoma, about 20%. Forecast during the overnight hours tonight, southerly winds. But here comes a cold front. There it is right there. Northerly winds stiff behind that front, running about 15 to 25 miles per hour. A patch or two of areas of showers, maybe a stray storm along that front. By tomorrow evening, that'll be south of Oklahoma and should have drying conditions into your Sunday. Future weather putting this into motion. There's those clouds thickening overnight tonight. We'll have some clouds around for your Saturday. Those clouds will be accompanied by some chances of rain. Then Saturday night into Sunday, that system clears out, and we're looking for a spectacular forecast for your Sunday. Warm things up to near 60, could even be warmer in some parts of the state. Upper 60s and low 70s, those will be forecast trends into next week. We also are tracking a pattern change more to the spring variety, and by middle to latter part of next week, it's going to become windy and possibly stormy. So our chances of severe weather so far during the month of March have been nearly nil. But April may be a little bit more active, especially as we get into the late part of next week. Hopefully that'll change, but got to keep an eye on it.
There's a reason about that saying about April showers.
Yeah.
So, all right. Thank you, Jed.
You bet.
Well, Casual for Kids is an event here in Oklahoma City that's trying to prevent child abuse. Ed Murray's in Bricktown with one of the supporters for the event. Good morning.
Good morning, Stacy. Rick Zurich of KQSR doing his radio gig back here at our Bricktown studios. Deanne Gaddis, the executive director of the Exchange Club, and she's here to talk about this Blue Ribbon campaign to knock out child abuse.
Yes, Casual for Kids is a Blue Ribbon campaign. In 1989, a grandmother in Virginia started the Blue Ribbon campaign because her grandson was killed by her daughter's boyfriend. And so we do a Casual for Kids Blue Ribbon campaign to remind people about child abuse and neglect and to help us support our efforts in child abuse prevention.
Talk about those efforts, Dan.
We've just had a merger with Prevent Child Abuse Oklahoma and the Parent Child Center. And so we have both primary, which is public awareness, and secondary in-home based family support services. So we are a statewide agency working to prevent child abuse and neglect in Oklahoma.
And again, tell us how this works. Here's the Casual for Kids Day. And just tell us how this works.
Casual for Kids is a corporate-sponsored program where employees are allowed to dress casual. This year it's April 5th, but can be any day in April. And they pay $2 and receive a sticker and are able to go casual that day.
Yeah, it sounds so easy, and yet you can raise so much money for this effort.
It is very easy, and we raised over $20,000 last year and are hoping to raise close to $30,000 this year to support our efforts.
And for businesses, it sounds like a low-maintenance type thing. Just get the employees together, and if they're casual that day, folks are going to talk about it, and then a chance to just spread the word.
That's exactly right, and the business gets to define casual, so it doesn't matter. We're not saying what they have to wear. They get to define casual, and their employees really enjoy the program.
And this is, unfortunately, this is a problem we have here in Oklahoma, and we need to do all we can to just get rid of it.
That's right. Although Oklahoma has shown a downward trend in the last 3 years, but we're still, if we stay on current tracks, we'll have close to 12,000 kids confirmed abused this year.
All right. So hopefully this campaign will go a long way, bringing that number down even more.
Yes, that's right. We're hoping that, too.
Again, Casual for Kids Day is April 5th, next Thursday, but it can be any day in April, as April is Prevent Child Abuse Month. Stacy?
All right. Thank you, Ed. Casual for Kids Day is Thursday, April 5th. Well, the stock market still has investors a little gun-shy. Coming up, CBS Early Show will have the latest in financial news. That's next. And back here on News 9, the Tecumseh School Board has decided to appeal a judge's decision on school drug testing. We'll have the latest coming up at 7:25. Right now, let's take a live look outside from your Mathis Brothers City Cam. You're looking there at I-44 and I-40. As you can tell, it's hazy out there. Jed Castle's been talking about patchy fog. Some places dense this morning. Take it easy on your drive to work or school. Just be slow. Keep some space between you and other drivers. At 7:16, it's 41 degrees. We'll be back.
Does it seem that some local news is as meaningful as watching paint dry? Not if you're watching News 9. Last week, we broke stories about proposed tax hikes in three towns, new direct flights from Will Rogers, and a ban on same-sex prom dates in Purcell. All total over 130 more local stories than any other station. Every day, News 9 continues to bring you more local news than any other news channel. Guaranteed. More local, more meaningful. News 9.
General Motors just sent Smicklas Chevrolet 50 2001 Suburbans and said sell them as fast as you can.
So here's our offer. Pick any Suburban. We'll discount it $5,000.
Pick the color you like, the equipment you want, get a $5,000 discount, and we'll throw in an OU National Championship football.
And get this, every Suburban comes with its own video center.
Suburbans discounted $5,000, more proof that in Oklahoma, Smicklas is Chevrolet.
Smicklas Chevrolet, 53rd North May Avenue.
Back now at 7:18, time for a look at the morning's headlines. Susan McGinnis is sitting in the news desk for Julie Chen. Good morning.
Good morning, Jane and Russ. Good morning, everyone. The McCain-Feingold campaign finance reform bill appears to have cleared its last Senate hurdle and is on its way to a final vote. Diana Olick is on Capitol Hill. Diana, good morning.
Good morning, Susan. So it may just be the ultimate survivor. The McCain-Feingold campaign finance reform bill is still alive this morning and set for a final vote on Monday. The bill would ban the unregulated soft money to political parties, which topped $480 million in the last 2 years. Late yesterday, backers of the bill won their greatest victory yet.
In a decisive 57-43 vote, campaign finance backers managed to defeat a dangerous poison pill.
Now, my friend John McCain knows how to put things very straight. He has said that non-severability is French for kill campaign finance reform. And I think he's right.
Non-severability would have meant that if any one part of the final bill was found to be unconstitutional, the whole bill would go down with the ship. Afterward, opponents began betting that the bill would pass the Senate in the end. Of course, it will still face a fight in the House.
We look forward to working with our House members, and we don't underestimate the challenge, but we are guardedly confident that we will pass it through the House of Representatives.
And then the next step would be the White House. And while President Bush hasn't exactly supported a ban on soft money, he has said that he will sign any bill that, quote, improves the system. And after the latest pardon scandals and the most expensive election in history, public sentiment has shifted toward reform. Susan?
All right, Diana Olick on Capitol Hill, thanks. Less than an hour before he was scheduled to die this morning, convicted Tennessee cop killer Philip Workman was given a stay of execution. Workman claims the police officer was mistakenly shot by another officer. A hearing will be held to examine new evidence. Israel is braced for new violence today. Israeli forces tightened security at checkpoints as Arabs and Palestinians planned their annual day of protests today. Israeli troops are prepared to enter Palestinian territories if necessary. Time for this morning's Market Watch. Finally, an end to a treacherous month on Wall Street. Today ends the first quarter as well, one where corporate profits saw their biggest drop in a decade. On Thursday, a mixed finish on Wall Street as profit worries keep investors on the defensive. After struggling all day long, the blue chips managed to escape the bear's grasp, the Dow gaining 13 points to 97.99. Big name tech stocks took a beating, though, sending the Nasdaq down 33 to 1820. Checking world markets, Tokyo stocks gave back some gains, but markets in Paris, Frankfurt, and London are higher. Some individual stocks, Tyson is chickening out, calling off a planned merger with beef packing giant IBP. Micron Technologies and an After the Bell report posted a loss as demand for computer chips fell, and reports say Citigroup may be interested in buying American Express. For more, head to cbs.marketwatch.com. Well, President Bush can have trouble saying certain words called Bushisms. Last night, he discussed that with tongue-in-cheek in a speech to Washington reporters.
And instead of barriers and tariffs, I said terriers and bariffs. And you know what? Life goes on.
And later, Mr. Bush thanked the reporters for their, quote, hospitality. And that's the news this morning. Back now to Jane and Russ. Thinks he can make fun of himself.
Thank you, Susan.
Thanks, Susan. Still ahead on the early show, our Survivor Roundtable guests sink their teeth into Jerry.
At 8:15, Jerry, the so-called evil woman of the Outback, joins us for a first live TV interview. Stay with us. You're watching the early show on CBS.
CBS Market Watch, sponsored by AXA Advisors. AXA Advisors, building futures.
People put off till tomorrow the things they should do today. It's easy, right?
Anthony Padilla, AXA Advisors.
Especially when it comes to a financial plan. I work with a lot of people my age. They say, Anthony, I'm young. What's the rush?
AXA Advisors is one-on-one financial help.
I say, start now. Sure, you've got a lot of expenses, but you've got this huge advantage, too, and that's time. Hey, I know it isn't easy, but my job is to get you started.
AXA Advisors, building futures.
New on video, Rugrats in Paris has something for everyone.
Finally, no turn down.
Wake me if you spot a hunchback.
It's not just for kids.
Really?
Rugrats in Paris, the movie, available on video and DVD.
5.8, 5.7, 6.0. Uh-oh.
Mounds and Almond Joy. Because everybody needs a five-minute vacation.
What did you have for dinner?
Last night I had microwave popcorn and cold spaghetti.
No big deal. The other night I had a pint of mint chocolate chip.
I had pizza that was older than me.
I had herb roasted chicken in a rich, creamy mushroom sauce with roasted red skin potatoes, broccoli, and red peppers. It was Lean Cuisine.
Do something good for yourself with Stouffer's Lean Cuisine. It's not just lean, it's cuisine.
Now you can clean without sprays and cleaners.
There's a smarter way.
No more sprays.
The Scotch-Brite high-performance cloth has a unique microtexture that lifts and captures dust and fingerprints.
Just wipe it away.
No more sprays.
Use the high-performance cloth over and over.
Don't toss it away.
There's a smarter way.
Without sprays with the high performance cloth.
Get it done right with Scotch-Brite.
I can't believe I waited so long to ask my doctor. It was just a couple of toenails, except they're all thick-like and yellow.
I tried treating it myself from the outside.
Nothing worked. So finally I just asked him. You know what he told me? It's an infection.
An infection? One that lives deep inside and under the nail.
He told me about Lamisil tablets. It's a prescription medicine that treats it deep in there where the infection lives.
Not just on the surface.
Nails it from the inside out.
Hey, it's the number one prescription for this infection.
After 3 months of treatment, I saw clear nails starting to grow.
Now my nails are looking good.
Lamisil isn't for people with liver or kidney problems. Rarely, serious side effects on the liver or serious skin reactions were reported. So your doctor may do blood tests. Other side effects, including headache, symptoms of stomach upset, indigestion, and rash, were generally mild.
Hey, you can't treat this yourself from the outside. You gotta see the doctor and ask him if Lamisil tablets are right for you.
Lamisil tablets. Nail the infection from the inside out.
Right now, you're looking out from our Integrus Baptist City cam, looking there at the Northwest Expressway at 725. It's 41 degrees this morning. A little foggy out there. Well, here's a look at this morning's top stories. An Oklahoma City police chemist is under investigation by the Federal Bureau of Investigation for possibly sending innocent people to prison and death row. The FBI is going to retest Joyce Gilchrist's work in situations where cases came down to her specific scientific analysis. We're told this is not a routine investigation. Tecumseh school officials say they will head back to court over a random drug testing policy. The district was testing students who participated in extracurricular activities, but the 10th U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals ruled the policy unconstitutional. For now, the school is not testing anyone. Let's head over now to Jed Castles. That look outside just looked a little foggy out there. Is it kind of sticking around for us?
Yeah, still some fog around this morning, Stacy, and you notice from that last camera shot and the one we have going on right now, let's check out that tower cam shot. You can see fog visibility is not all that bad across most of the metro, but you're going to encounter a few locations, especially those low-lying areas, your river valley areas. Fog will be fairly dense here starting out this morning. So if you are driving about, you encounter some of that fog, slow it down and keep those dims on. It's 41 right now, and we are tracking a few rain showers down along the Red River from just west of Elk City down near Altus and Ardmore. That rain is moving east-southeast, so the best chances of rain should be south of an Elk City to Ardmore line coming up this morning. Around the metro, looks dry and mild. Forecast highs rebounding up to near 61 today under partly cloudy skies. Changing weather forecast for your Saturday. Winds increase. Northwest winds 15 to 25. Blustery and turning cooler. Temperatures will fall through the 50s tomorrow with chances of rain at 30%. Nice day Sunday. Highs near 60. How about that forecast into next week? Finally, spring again. We'll look for those mild temperatures in the 60s and 70s through most of next week. More details coming up.
All right. Thank you, Jen. Let's head over now to Catherine Pegram, get a look at your traffic. Good morning, Catherine.
Good morning, Stacy. Good morning, everyone. The patchy fog that Jed's been talking about is not causing any problems for drivers at this point. We've been checking around in the metro, and everything is up to speed for drivers. But again, keep it slow and keep the low beams on just in case you do hit one of those patches. We just have one accident still working, Northwest 122nd and Meridian. So just be aware if you're headed that way anytime soon. Let's take a look outside right now from our Mathis Brothers City Cam. We're looking at traffic build along I-44 southbound there to the Amarillo Junction. Also seeing quite a few cars I-44 northbound as well. Very busy I-40 westbound, Sunny Lane to the Fort Smith Junction, and I-35 northbound through the crossroads, waking up pretty nicely as well. I want to let you know about a little bit of work along I-40 today. The eastbound I-40 off-ramp at Peabody Road will be closed between 9 o'clock today, this morning, and noon. Crews are going to be cleaning up some debris around the area, so just be aware of that for this morning. And another check across town from our Oklahoman cam, and most of those cars working their way south towards downtown along the Broadway extension. Everything again up to speed for those drivers, but again, getting pretty busy out there. Normal pace of traffic on a Friday morning. I also checked with Metro buses. They're still running right on time and no delays at the airport, thankfully, due to the fog. That's your look at traffic right now. Stacy, back to you.
All right. Thank you, Catherine. Well, the cool weather may drive people to the movie theater this weekend. Coming up, we'll hear from one of the Oklahoman's entertainment reporters. She'll tell us about some of the new movies. We'll be back.
This is Miss America 1996 and Oklahoma native Chantel Smith, here to welcome you to Oklahoma's very own theme park, Frontier City. This is the Wild West the way it should have been, with rides wilder than a herd of Mustangs on caffeine, and more action than a three-ring rodeo. It's a great escape for kids and families, and it's right here close to home. There's a lot more to Frontier City than you may think, like the newest thrill ride, Hangman, an incredible new free-fall sensation. So get set for Western-style excitement at Oklahoma's very own Frontier City. Just remember, you've got a frontier to ride.
Toyota's big event. Now, there's a Toyota and a Toyota sales event for everyone. You'll find incredible values on Toyota's largest inventory ever, with 16 different Toyotas to choose from. Now, Toyota 4Runner has a new lower price, and all these options are now standard equipment. Toyota 4Runner, the SUV that delivers more for less. Get the Toyota you've always wanted now, during Toyota's big event. See your Toyota dealer today.
Mill Creek announces the introduction of Mohawk Carpet's new Innovations Collection. Now at Mill Creek, you can shop all 20 of Mohawk's spring selections, featuring the newest in frisees and cut Berbers. They're made with Anso Crush Resistor 3 Nylon, designed for fashion, engineered for performance. These totally new Mohawk carpets with Anso Crush Resistor 3 are beautiful and are at low introductory prices. It's another reason why nobody knows carpet like Mill Creek.
Welcome back. Several new movies are set to hit the big screen today. Ed Murray's in Bricktown with the Oklahoman Sandy Davis. Ed, Sandy has the scoop on a couple of these new movies.
She certainly does, Stacy. She just got back from Los Angeles, as a matter of fact, where she got to view a couple of them ahead of us. But that's one of the perks of the business, isn't it, Sandy? Hello.
Hi, how are you doing?
Doing great.
Well, good. Yes, a couple of weeks ago, flew to Los Angeles. I actually saw six movies, but two of them were Someone Like You and Spy Kids. I want to recommend both of those movies, especially if you need a great romantic comedy and you'd like to see what Hugh Jackman looks like out of the Wolverine makeup from the X-Men. Go for it. Also, Ashley Judd is stunning in her romantic comedy debut. It's a great comedy. I laughed and I cried, and I very rarely admit that I will cry in a movie, but this one worked.
All right, Sandy, I'll tell you what, you brought clips with us. Let's talk to one you haven't seen, but one of your fellow writers has seen, Tomcats. I think we have a clip of that one.
Yes. Scott Schultz saw this, and he gave it one star.
That's not a lot, is it?
No, we work on a four-star system, and this is a story of three guys, and they put their money together and place a bet on whoever gets married last gets the pot. Well, it's a couple of years later. One guy's already married. There's two guys left. One guy has a gambling debt he has to settle, so he decides to marry off his friend, and that's the premise of the movie, and Jerry O'Connell is in it. He was in Mission to Mars. He was also in Sliders. And Jake Busey is in it. And that's Gary Busey's son, which you would know right away the first time you see him smile.
Okay. Let's get to one you do like, Spy Kids. Again, you've seen this.
I saw Spy Kids. It was the first movie I saw in Los Angeles. And it is James Bond meets Willy Wonka. Parents will love it. Children will love it. It's a story of a family. Antonio Banderas, Carla Gugino, Alexa Vega is the daughter. Daryl Sabara is the son. And the kids think their parents are the most boring people in the world. And then they find out they're international spies. The parents are kidnapped. The kids have to go get them. And the kids get to play with all the great gadgets. And the villain is like something out of Willy Wonka. It's called Mr. Floop. And it's a fun movie. I was delighted with it. I can't wait to see it again. And I think this could be the foundation of a franchise or a series.
And someone like you, you've talked about a little bit about it already.
Yes, I loved Someone Like You. If you'll read the paper today, I did an interview with Ashley Judd, and my review is in there. I also have a story on the children from Spy Kids, and Gene Triplett has a story on a movie that's now out on video called Girl Fight. So, you know, that's pretty much what's going on the movie business today, and I'll be flying out in about 3 hours to see another one.
All right, and you loved Ashley Judd when you talked to her.
I really did. She's very nice. She brought her dog with her. She has a cockapoo named Buttermilk. They got to run around her room, so we all got to play with the dog. And she has a huge diamond ring. Yeah. She would not tell us how big it was, but she's getting married to a race car driver. I believe his name is Dario Franchetti.
All right, and again, right there on the front of today's Daily Oklahoma. And also, as always, Sandy's top five things to do this weekend. Sandy, thanks for coming by this morning.
My pleasure.
All right, Sandy Davis, the Daily Oklahoman. Stacy?
All right. Thank you, Ed. For total coverage of the movie openings this weekend and show times, pick up today's copy of the Daily Oklahoman. Stay with us.
Want a choice in long distance? Get the plan you want from the experts you trust, AT&T. Call 1-888.
Hi, folks. Dean Blevins for Hudiburg's March Madness. The field is set, and every Hudiburg team has made the cut.
Hudiburg Pontiac GMC has 0% for 60-month financing on GMCs like Jimmy. Hudiburg Toyota has Tundras at $15,599. Hudiburg Nissan in South OKC has Ultimas starting at $13,488 with 3.9 for 60-month financing and no money down.
You'll get unbeatable price, selection, and service at both Hudiburg locations.
Hudiburg, unbeatable.
You and your loved ones have enough on your minds at a time like this. How to pay for an unexpected ambulance ride shouldn't be part of it. Without insurance, ambulance service can cost as much as $800. But with Total Care from EMSA, you and your immediate family are covered for all emergency ambulance service for a full year for as little as $50. Enrollment in Total Care 2001 ends March 31st, so hurry and enroll today. Total Care 2001 from EMSA. Security at a price you can live with.
Frank and Eileen just love their new Dixon ZTR riding mower. Frank loves it because it cuts mowing time in half. He loves not having to stop and go, back up, or shift gears. He loves the zero turning radius that lets Dixon turn on a dime with just a touch of the levers. Eileen loves their new Dixon, too, because it's fun. The Dixon ZTR riding mower. Is it my turn yet?
Well, if the polls were right, then Americans were rooting for Survivor's Jerry to get the boot. Manuel Gallegos watched last night's show with former Survivor team member Sonia. Here's what she thought of Jerry.
The tribe has spoken. You're the first one voted off.
Won't yep, Sonia Christopher and her ukulele were the first ones thrown off Survivor, even though Richard seemed to like her music.
Sun is shining, no more whining.
Sonia is truly nice, but in this show, nice guys seem to finish last.
I probably was Pollyannish about it. I so much wanted it to be about a Robinson Crusoe survival experience.
Sonia is the only one of the original survivors we've talked with who says she would not do it again. The new show is just a little too slick for her, especially the players.
They obviously are the kind of people who want to play a game, who are willing to be devious to do it.
Like Jerry.
If
5 votes, Jerry. That's enough.
Even though everyone in America was happy to see her get voted off, in real life, she may be all right.
I wonder how Jerry deals with this. This is one thing that people probably forget, is that these survivors are real people. They're not characters that appear on soap operas.
See, she really is nice. As for her life now,
it has been a marvelous journey. It's opened doors you never thought would be opened. Where the toggies, pugongs, and the rattans once got to live.
Not bad.
That was bad.
Very good. I love it.
You guys put me on the spot.
One door that opened for Sonia is something she really believes in. She is now a spokesperson for breast cancer awareness. She is a breast cancer survivor. Manuel Gallegos, CBS News, Hollywood.
Don't miss the latest survivor to get the boot. Jerry will be on the CBS Early Show this morning at 8:15. Hear what she has to say about her time in Australia.
Ah, little scoops. You crack it open and you scoop. Scoop. You scoop, 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 scoop. One more time.
Mom! Little Scoops by Milka. Scoop them up this Easter.
One remarkable event.
Oh, here they go.
Welcome to Nissan's Tournament Time Sales Event.
Score big when you drive home a winner.
Maxima with what may be the best V6 engine ever.
Sentra, a Consumer's Digest Best Buy, starting at $11,649.
And Altima with 3.9 financing for 60 months and $2,900 in total savings. Can't beat those stats.
Hurry to your Nissan dealer before the clock runs out. Nissan's Tournament Time Sales Event absolutely ends Monday, April 2nd. Nissan Driven.
You hold the keys to a cure. The American Cancer Society would like you to donate your car in the fight against cancer. By donating your vehicle, you will receive an itemized tax deduction. The American Cancer Society will pick up your car and auction it off today. The money raised by the car you donated will help fund the cancer programs and education. For more information, please call your local American Cancer Society in the Heartland Division.
Please call 1-800-733-9888 for more information.
For more fun and all your soft rock favorites, it's Magic 104.1 KMGL.
No matter how busy you are, there's always time to find great values at McDonald's.
Right now, we're serving up our 2 for $2 deals. That means $2 buys you two of our delicious Filet-O-Fish sandwiches. In the morning, swing by for two classic Egg McMuffin sandwiches, because they're also $2. Grab two for $2. How can you resist?
If you're going to buy any carpet or flooring this year, now's the time to buy and save like never before. It's the Carpet and Floor World DuPont Carpet Blowout. Save on DuPont Stainmaster Carpet with the advanced Teflon Repel System. Blowout tiles from $1.05 a square foot. Also get giant savings on DuPont Stainmaster Ultralife Carpet from Trustmark by Shaw Industries. Buy now and get our blowout prices, plus 6 months no interest and zero down. Hurry, buy the carpet of your dreams at blowout prices. Get professional installation, plus zero interest and zero down. It's the Carpet and Floor World DuPont Carpet Blowout. Two locations, north and in Midwest City.
I don't even know why I bother. You're not even listening now, are you? Do you want to go home?
People do some strange things to cars. That's why there's Carfax. We'll give you the real history of any used car. Go to Carfax.com or ask your dealer for a Carfax report.
Well, Oklahomans have a chance to help stop child abuse before it starts. The radio station KQSR is one of the sponsors for an event called Casual for Kids. Ed Murray's down in Bricktown with that radio station this morning. Good morning, Ed.
Good morning, Stacy. Rick Zurich is busy once again. Ever since every cut-in, Rick's been busy back here. He's talking about Casual for Kids with the Exchange Club behind it. You got a minute, Rick?
I do, yeah. I just want to make sure that we thank you folks with News 9 for working with KQSR and the Exchange Club and Prevent Child Abuse Oklahoma on making this program a big success, because your help really does make a difference, so thank you.
All right. Thank you, Rick. I know you got some work to do there. Talking to Deanna of the Exchange Club. With me is Sherry Fair with the Oklahoma City Public Schools, and this is an event, an organization that you really throw your support behind.
Yes, we do. We have been with them since the beginning, and 5 years ago we made it a district-wide event. And we really enjoy supporting this, because since we are in the business of kids, this is a mission statement we can really get behind.
And it's something very easy for an organization to do, get involved with, and raise a lot of money.
Oh, it is. First of all, to get involved is very inexpensive. It's $2 for the sticker, and you get a dress casual for a day, which is really an incentive for a lot of us. And you also have the option of buying a T-shirt, but this is something we really enjoy doing. And every year we have progressively raised more money for them. And this year we're trying to raise between $4,500 and $5,000.
And again, you can pick which day. April 5th is the Casual for Kids Day, but the entire month of April is Prevent Child Abuse Month, so you can do it anytime. And the business gets to decide exactly what casual dress is.
We do. We let them wear jeans, and they can wear their T-shirt if they purchase a T-shirt, or they can just wear any other acceptable attire on the top part of their body.
Well, Sherry, thank you for being a part of it. I know your organization doing a lot of good for kids in a lot of ways.
Thank you.
Sherry Fair with Oklahoma City Public Schools. And again, it's very easy to get involved with. Just contact the Exchange Club, and they've got all the information for you. Stacy?
All right, great. Thank you, Ed. If your company or organization would like to participate in April's Casual for Kids event, you can contact the Exchange Club Parent Child Center at 232-2500. Well, having trouble with your knees can sometimes make life difficult. Coming up, the CBS Early Show will have helpful hints for those who suffer from knee problems. That's next. And back here on News 9, you might have thought your gas bill would go down as it gets warmer, but ONG is asking to raise your rates. We'll have that story at 7:55. Let's take a look outside from your Oklahoma City cam. We'll be back.
This anniversary, give her forever.
A 3-stone diamond anniversary ring from Ray Ward Fine Jewelers.
In downtown Ardmore.
Your Southern Oklahoma diamond destination.
You know how when you go to buy a car and you're thinking, this time I'm going to get the car I want and not end up with some car that's eh?
Get the SUV you want, like a loaded 2001 Explorer Sport. Pick your color and take $3,500 off a Hudiburg Ford, or get a 2000 Ford Contour, $9,600 or zero down, $179 a month.
Come see us here at Hudiburg Ford. With our great selection, you'll find the car you want, then we'll give you a really good price on it. And then you'll drive away saying, next time I'm going back
to Hudiburg Ford.
You don't like paying taxes. Neither do we. It's pre-inventory. We want to sell it, not count it, and pay taxes on it. It's a wall-to-wall in-store pre-inventory warehouse liquidation. We're passing the savings on to you. This 60-inch Mitsubishi Giant Screen is digital TV ready, loaded with features in just $19.99 and totally free till January 2002. Mitsubishi 4-head Hi-Fi VCR start at just $89. Get a Dish Network digital two-room satellite system for just $49. Buy now and get free installation. It's the pre-inventory warehouse liquidation at Sight and Sound. We beat all competitors' prices every day.
Who said you have to be a size 4 to be happy? And who made the rule that water couldn't come in pretty colors? Fruity flavors, 5 calories. Enjoy yourself. It's all good for you.
More local, more meaningful. You're watching News 9.
The Early Show continues now from the General Motors Building at Trump Plaza in New York City.
The knee is fast becoming an Achilles heel for many young female athletes. Studies show they're 3 to 8 times more likely to suffer ACL or anterior cruciate ligament injuries than males. Annie Raritan is a high school hoop star from Kentucky. She's been watching her team struggle in this year's state tournament after she ripped her ACL in November.
Yeah, it hurt. It hurt a lot. I heard a loud pop and just throbbing pain. And that's the first thing that popped in my head was ACL, not for the season.
Our fitness contributor, Mina Lessig, has some preventative measures that you can take to avoid knee injuries. Good morning.
Good morning, Jane.
So how bad is it for women? Are we more susceptible for knee injuries?
Generally speaking, yes, because of our anatomical differences. Wider hips and less developed leg muscles, so that alone puts pressure on the ACL.
And I suspect during, you know, times of pregnancy and other stresses, it gets worse.
Oh, yeah. You know, another thing is women don't use their muscles as efficiently. They don't absorb shock as much. When they're jumping and landing, they don't bend their knees as much. So I've got a few things to show you that can help.
Okay, great.
Well, first of all, it's important to strengthen all of the muscles in the legs, front, back, inner, and outer. The slide board really gets the inner and outer thighs tremendously. It actually was first originally developed for knee rehabilitation purposes, and then it kind of got taken on into the health clubs. You can do all sorts of fancy stuff. You can go into the center, work all of the leg muscles, really squeezing in the inner thighs, so it's something
really
fun
to use your muscles so that you don't pop way out.
That's
the
true.
Splits to the side,
that's,
right?
That's right.
Now, this is so good, this power slide, because you can transport it really anywhere.
Yes, definitely.
You can roll it up, take it with you.
It's easy
How
to
much
and
for
you're
something
getting
like
your,
this,
you're,
Mina?
You're getting your cardio workout, too. I think $100 maybe.
Really?
Some are maybe even less, $50.
And a good cardio workout, you say.
Great. Look at him. Out of breath a little bit. Okay, let me pop the booties off.
These look like hospital booties.
They'll do me good in the rain today.
Except they're gray instead of green. Okay.
Another key thing to do is balance work. So it'll help strengthen the muscles to become more better at stabilizing the knee joint. So something like in yoga, where you're standing on one foot and you're doing a leg extension, you're working the quadriceps, and you can see the base leg. I'm shaking a little bit to keep my balance.
Mm-hmm.
So that strengthens all the muscles. You might even want to do it eyes closed and really try and keep your balance with something like that.
And if you have knee injuries, are there ways to do these exercises so that you don't hurt it even more, re-injure an old injury?
Well, that would be definitely rehabilitative type of work. And again, slide work is good for that.
Okay.
And a lot of yoga exercises too.
Okay.
Another thing is plyometric work. Now, knee-friendly jumping, like box jumps up and down onto the steps, helps to train muscle memory so that you do remember to absorb shock on the landings, helps train the muscles to be more explosive and to be able to respond better to sudden stop-and-go movements. Anything from lateral side hops to box jumps up and down on the steps will help with that component, even jumping rope.
And you don't worry that's too much pressure on your knees when you jump up there.
Again, these are preventative type of exercises. So yeah, they're very demanding, but if you have knee problems, that's a whole nother story.
Okay. What about those lunges that you do?
Oh, compound movements.
We don't have much time.
Compound movements are great, strengthening front and back of the legs, inner and outer, everything.
All right, Mina,
I could
thank
go
you.
On. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. We're back at 8 with Jerry. We're back after this.
CBS Health Watch, sponsored by Claritin.
From spring to fall, it's in the air. From the Sunshine Leagues of Florida to the schoolyards of New York to the golden fields of California, it's allergy season. So talk to your doctor about Claritin, the number one prescribed antihistamine in America. And when the ump yells play ball, you'll be ready. Claritin, the official allergy medication of Major League Baseball. Claritin has a low occurrence of side effects such as headache, drowsiness, fatigue, and dry mouth, similar to sugar pill.
Pepperidge Farm Raisin Swirl Bread. With sweet cinnamon and plump, juicy raisins. Everything else is toast. Pepperidge Farm. Never have an ordinary day.
Roundup.
What, Papa?
Roundup. Never forget that name. It will be your greatest enemy when you take over the weed family.
Me? Leave the family? Papa!
Pay attention. New Roundup is twice as strong now. Faster than ever. It kills right down to the root.
Stronger. Faster. No!
Yes. And there's no growing back.
So when I take over, we'll all be dead?
New Roundup. Twice as strong. Faster than ever. Roundup. No root. No weed. No problem.
I would never tell anyone about your crush on the mailman.
I'll never mention how you cry during major programs.
And holler out the answers at quiz shows.
As long as you save me a spot in the middle of your newspaper.
Purina One knows that no relationship is like the one with your cat. Purina One brand is like no other cat food. And it helps support a strong immune system and sustain strong muscles. For the health and happiness of your cat. Purina One. How great relationships are fed.
Mounds and Almond Joy, because everybody needs a five-minute vacation.
A fabulous Final Four. Arizona battles the defending champs, Michigan State. Then Maryland collides with ACC rival Duke. Saturday on CBS.
Having an affair with attorney Tom Capano was her first mistake. Trying to leave would be her last.
They're looking for a missing girl.
And never let her go, CBS Sunday.
This is a News 9 traffic report.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Catherine Pegram, just before 8 o'clock on this Friday morning. And heavy traffic in the metro right now, but nothing out of the ordinary. Unfortunately, or fortunately, the normal pace of traffic on a Friday morning as folks head into work one last time this week. We checked some of that traffic there from our Oklahoma cam. There's a little bit of patchy fog out there in some places. So just make sure to keep it slow and keep your low beams on if you hit some of that. Very busy out there on the Broadway extension, filling up and slowing down. But again, the normal pace of traffic. Another check across town from our Mathis Brothers City cam as we see traffic
traffic build along I-44 southbound there to the Amarillo Junction. Also very busy I-44 northbound, I-40 westbound around the Fort Smith Junction, busy as well as the Crosstown, and I-35 through the Crossroads, picking up some pretty good steam there as well. Want to let you know about a little bit of work you can expect on I-35 today. The right lane of northbound I-35 will be closed from Northeast 23rd to 63rd Street Bridge from about 9 o'clock this morning to 3 o'clock this afternoon. Crews are going to be doing some patching work there. I checked with Metro buses. They're still running right on time, and no delays at the airport because of any of that fog. That's your look at traffic, Stacy.
All right. Thank you, Catherine. Well, here's a final look at today's top stories. Defense attorneys for bombing co-conspirator Terry Nichols have not asked for an interview with bomber Timothy McVeigh. McVeigh may claim to be the only person responsible for the bombing in his upcoming book. Our legal analyst Irvin Box says this could be used to help get Nichols off the hook in his state trial. An Oklahoma City police chemist is under investigation by the Federal Bureau of Investigation for possibly sending innocent people to prison and death row. The FBI is going to retest Joyce Gilchrist's work in cases where the court case came down to her scientific analysis. We're told this is not a routine investigation. Oklahoma Natural Gas will meet with the Corporation Commission later this morning. ONG will ask if they can add a new temporary surcharge of $5.50 to every bill. The gas company also wants to raise rates 50 cents per unit. Don Sherry with ONG says they need to recover more than $63 million in natural gas they weren't paid for this winter. If the surcharge is approved, customers will see it on their bill next month. Well, coming up on News 9 at noon, do you know how at risk you are to get breast cancer? A new study suggests many women overestimate their risk of developing breast cancer, but doctors say don't ignore the potential risk. Coming up at noon, we'll tell you what your chances are of developing breast cancer. Let's head back down to Ed one more time in Bricktown. Ed, you've had a good day, haven't you?
Certainly have, Stacy. QSR folks, Rick Zurich here this morning talking about the Casual for Kids, help stamp out child abuse. Again, it's April 5th that your business can get involved. April 5th, also the day in Chickasha, USAO having its big event, sidewalk chalking and music as they have their annual recruitment with high school kids. Also, tomorrow's a day of volunteering. You can call Heart to Heart International. You want to get involved in some community service. And Sandy Davis, the Daily Oklahoman, says the movie to take your kids to this weekend, Spy Kids. You'll enjoy it. And hey, Stacy, Jed, let me show you. You may enjoy this too. I know it'll probably whack our camera out, but if you go outside our studio here, the sun is out in Bricktown. It's a beautiful sight.
That is the best thing we've seen, isn't it, Ed? All right, thank you. Looks nice.
Good. Oh, yeah.
Looks better.
Yeah, if we get that sunshine going, we're doing just fine. Mm-hmm. We'll take that sun and we'll take the temperatures with it, too. Highs today up near 61 degrees. Tomorrow, another cold front moving in. That'll bring in some blustery winds and cooler 50s. Chance of rain tomorrow at 30%. But once that moves out, conditions warm up nicely. We'll be back up in the 60s and 70s. 670s also on the way as we head into next week. We'll have a full update in the next hour and again at noon today.
That's right. Thank you, Jed. And keep it here on News 9. We'll keep you updated on news as well throughout the hour. Have a great Friday. We'll be back.